imagine somebody, you know, writing a song like that, that has written tips of my fingers and five little fingers and
peel me a nana
off and peel me a nana and all kinds of things like that.
I asked Bill one time, I said, I just have to ask you, how can any one person who can write the most tender, touching, beautiful melody and lyrics of Still, and then write Peel Me a Nanner? He said it was a very long tour. You know, I was talking to one of my other girlfriends who was married to a songwriter years ago, and I said, you know, stop and think about it. Songwriters make up stories. I mean, they're not. It has to be something they made up. Why do we expect them to tell us the truth? You know, expect that songwriter to tell you the truth, man. It's like, well, you know, if he didn't make up stuff, he'd be stealing somebody else's. It has to be original. You know? Of course, I always thought that a melody is the only thing that separated a songwriter from just an ordinary liar.
You ought to know you's married to one of the best.
Both liars and writers.
You know, there's all kinds of songwriters that where am I at? I am a plumber for the city. I clean your pipes and fix your sinks. Working day and night in a job that really stinks. I hear you singing in the choir. I hear you bubbling in the tub. I sneak a peeky through the window. Oh baby, rubby dub 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 dub.
Did you write that?
Don't make fun of Peel Me a Nanner. At least mine got recorded.
You know, I can't compete with these two when it comes to writing. Maxine and I wrote some songs way back yonder in the early 50s, but then I quit. And I don't know why I never have written anything else, but that little thing right there, you know, I thought that was kind of cute, really.
You talking about my song or Jeannie?
Oh, Jeannie's different. She's really good. I love sit by her. She's always good looking. You know, we wrote 1954. We wrote a song called Looking Back to Sea. 1953, actually, we wrote it. And then came along. Here today and gone tomorrow. Our love will always be getting more better. I know you love me, but you're just a wanderer. Today I love you, but tomorrow I may not care. For absence never makes the heart grow fonder. I get lonesome for someone's company. You're here today and gone tomorrow, and my loving was just a fantasy. We wrote that about a baseball player. Actually, he was a third baseman for the Pine Bluff Judges. Maxine fell in love with him, and she come home one night and she said, "I've been in love with him." And I said, "What do you mean?" She said, "Well, he's here today and gone tomorrow." I said, "Let's write it."
I bought that record. I have that record at home.
Here you go. Can I have a copy of it? Because I don't have one.
You can't have mine.
Well, I was just sitting here thinking as he was singing that, you know, there was a time in my life too when my brother and I sang, growing up in Pennsylvania, and we used to sing the Browns things, singing those two songs, and never in my wildest dreams would I be sitting beside you sharing a stage. And I think of it often, Jimmy, and just wanted you to know that.
Thank you. That's nice.
You were my hero when I was a little boy, too, Jimmy.
Mike, you think we need to leave? This young man, he plays guitar with me and has been with me now for almost 28 years, I think it is, something like that. This is Mike Baker on the record. I think it's Jeannie's turn.
It's my turn again. Well, you want to do a song? You know, since we're doing songs we've written, and I haven't written that many that anybody knows, but this song has been really, really good for me. And, you know, it's amazing to me. Billy was talking earlier about how Bill writes all the time, and he has kept up with the times, and he sets the writing appointments as is the way to do it today. And I think I'm just lazy, to be honest about it, but but I've never written that way. I've always written from something I experienced, and believe me, I experienced this one. We were all in Chicago doing one of those big shows. A lot of you might remember when we used to do the 2 o'clock in the afternoon, the 8 o'clock, and there was an ice storm, and the buses couldn't go anywhere, so we were sitting there, and as always, passing the guitar around, and Farron Young was on the show, and so I sang this song I had just written, and Farron said, "I want that song as soon as I get home, and I'll record it." And I really didn't believe him. I'd never been brave enough to pitch a song to Farron for many reasons, those of you who know Farron. But anyway, he called me as soon as we got back to town. He did record it, and I'd like to sing it for you and thank Farron one more time. He's looking over us. It's called Leaving and Saying Goodbye. Before, but
are y'all ready for this?
About during that time, I did tried to leave Hank one time. Those of you who remember, I was married to songwriter Hank Cochran, one of the greatest songwriters of our time, and not really worth much as a husband, I will say. Anyway, I did try to leave him one time. We were living out in Hendersonville on the lake, so I went all the way to the other side of town, I don't even remember where now, and rented an apartment, rented all this furniture and everything. And he found out where I was, and he came over, conned them into letting him in the apartment, and he just wrecked the entire apartment. Lamps and everything. I tell this now because the Hank, God love him, is gone now. But anyway, he just wrecked the old apartment and everything. And so when I came home and I saw it, I knew who had done it. So I just called the office and told them I was leaving. They could rent the apartment again. And called the furniture rental and said, send the bill to Pamper Music, 119 Two Mile Pike. So he got the bill for it. And I went back home, wrote a song.
Anybody here? Anybody here ever watch Country's Family Reunion on television? Thank you. This reminds me of those shows where we sit around and talk and tell stories. Have a good time. If you get the RFD network, I hope you'll watch it whenever you can. Can I do a brand new song?
Yeah.
I thought you just did one.
No, that one's several months old now. Yeah. I want to do one that me and a couple of my buddies wrote about 2 weeks ago. I don't know all the words, so I'm going to cheat and read them. I hope. Do y'all get nervous when you do a new song for the first time?
Oh, yeah.
Oh, I won't do it.
You start with the second one? All right, this is only the second time I've ever done this. This little gathering tonight is called the Countryest of the Country, right? I gotta get this.
Sound a little like the amateurish of the amateurs.
Well, I thought since this gathering is called the Countryest of the Country, that I would debut this song tonight. Let me tell you about who I wrote this with. I wrote it with a dear friend of mine and a great songwriter named Bobby Tomberlin, who wrote a song called One More Day that Don and Rio had a monster hit on. And a young new artist, and I want you to remember this name because I think you're gonna hear this name, and he is country, boys and girls, and he is brand new. He's just signed a recording contract with Curb Records. He's from up in Illinois, and his name is Mo, just M-O, Mo Pitney, like Gene Pitney, if you remember, no relation. But Mo Pitney and Bobby Tomberlin and I got together and wrote this about 2 weeks ago. We're hoping Mo's going to record it on his first sessions for Curb, but if he doesn't, I might. And if I don't, maybe we'll get somebody to sell some records to record it. At a show called The Countryest of the Country, this song has a one-word title. It's called Country. Guitar on your front porch in the morning when the sun was rising, or followed your dog down to the river and run into an old baptizing. Do you think to pull off to the side of the road when a big black hearse is passing? Have you ever reached out to somebody in need without them even asking? They do that in the country. Let me tell you about country. Country is more than just a pickup truck and a party with the tailgate down. Taking your beer and your girl to the lake and spreading your blanket on the ground.
climbing up high on that big old tractor. You don't even know how to crank. Or your iPod shuffle being full of songs by Johnny Cash, Willie, and Hank. That don't make you country. Hey, let me tell you about country. Country can be in the middle of the city. Country can be on a farm. Country can be much more than just a map. Country's a place in your heart. Would you ever hitch a ride down to Music City just to see an opera show? Would you drive across the country just to listen to some country? Have you ever been there on the courthouse square for the parade on the 4th of July? With a tear on your face and a lump in your throat, watching Old Glory go by. Have you sat through a service where they played taps for a soldier who never came home? Or looked in the sad brown eyes of his mama as she touched his name on that stone? He died for his country. He fought for his country. I love my country. Hey, let me tell you about country.
We'll take a little break.